guys, welcome to Trinity Youth. We can't meet together this week, which is a shame, but we're really hoping that we'll be back in the building by next week. So let's all join in online and tune into the video together.
I hope that we're all well. I am in my fifth self-isolation and it is killing me. I'm sorry that we can't meet together. I'm sorry that we can't gather together in the building. So hopefully next week we're going to be able to do that. But we're back to YouTube just for now. Just for this week, and I just wanted to share a really quick thought about what I've been thinking about, what I've been praying about over the last few days of lockdown, which has been horrible. I found myself wondering, asking questions of God, where are you? God, what are you doing? God, I don't get why I'm here again. I don't like it. I'm trapped with my own thoughts. I'm trapped with my own thinking. And God, I feel like I'm in this pit, and it's not been pleasant. Questions, doubts, worries, fears, anxiety. When you're just trapped, you're left with your own thoughts. And I've been wondering what on earth God is doing. And for days, I've not had an answer. For days, I've not known. For days, I've not understood what God is doing. And I don't know if you guys can relate to that, where you find yourself in a place and you just don't know what God is doing. Where you just don't know why you feel the way that you feel, where you just don't know how you're going to get out of the position that you're in or what you're going to do. And we try and shake ourselves free, or we try and scramble our way out of a situation. But sometimes we find ourselves in a pit where we can see the ceiling, where we can see the way out, but we don't know how to get there. I don't know if we can relate to that, but that's certainly where I've been at over the last few days. And I thought this morning, you know, I feel like I'm in this pit. I feel like I'm surrounded by everything that's going off at the minute. Who in the Bible can relate to that? And then I felt like my attention got drawn to the guy Joseph in the Bible. And for those of you who don't know Joseph, you find him in the latter part of the first book in the Bible, Genesis. He was the son of Jacob or Israel. And Joseph was a special son. Joseph was favoured. And Joseph gets given this dream, and his life really is an up and down roller coaster. If you've ever heard the phrase life is a roller coaster, Joseph knows all about that. He gets given this dream, and he gets given this dream that his brothers will bow down to him. And then he gets sold by his brothers. So he's in the pit, but then he gets released, that sense of in this high position working for this guy who was sold to. But then he gets accused of something. So he's back in this pit. And he finds himself in prison with this baker and this cupbearer. But the thing that struck me, the thing that I found really fascinating, in chapter 39 of Genesis, verse 21, it says, but the Lord was with him. Joseph was in a pit. Joseph was accused. Joseph was sold by his family. And things will get worse from this point on if you read on. And things will get better. But the thing that struck me was the simple verse, in verse 21, but the Lord was with him. And I don't know about you guys, but sometimes that brings me hope. Sometimes that makes me frustrated, because it sometimes feels like God isn't with you. It sometimes feels like God is nowhere to be seen. But the thing is, the Lord was with Joseph. And I don't know how Joseph was feeling in that pit. And I don't know what he was thinking or where his thinking was going. Was his thinking going to when he was with his family? Was his thinking going to when he was given this dream? Was his thinking going when he was free, working upstairs with Potiphar? Was his thinking going when he had favour, when things were going well? Where was his thinking in that moment? And I can imagine that it wasn't where we think it was. I can imagine that it wasn't where he feels like God is with him. I can imagine it doesn't feel like God is right near to him. But the thing that fascinates me is the fact that God was still with him when it feels like he wasn't. Friends, I know this can be a hard reality to hear, and I'm living it right now, that God was still with him when he felt like he was miles away. God was still with him. So the thing that I want to encourage you with, as we've taken a break from our vision series to look at this week, is that God is with you. God is as real to you as the person sat next to you, or the chair that you're sat on, or the walls that surround you. God is as real as the air or the sky. He's as real as the clouds or the water that we drink. He is with you tangibly right now. And he's inviting us to ask him to make ourselves aware of his presence. to make ourselves aware of his presence when he feels so far off and we feel miles away. He's with us now, in a time of confusion, in a time of frustration, in a time of anxieties, worries, fears about tomorrow and next year and next month, about what's going to happen to us and our country. God is with you. I know it seems cliche, and I know we've heard this thousands and thousands of times if we've been brought up around church, but the truth is real, that God is with you and he's inviting you to draw near to him.
Arise, my soul, remember this. He took my sin and he buried it. No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light. I won't boast, but in the cross that saved my soul, all else is lost. The grip of fear has no hold on me. So where, oh death, where is your sting? No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light. Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory.
Sing this together.
Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory. No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light. Woke up to see the light. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All of this for your glory. 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 No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light.
Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
I thought I would end this video with a really simple recipe for Rice Krispie Cakes. And you may be thinking, we all know how to make Rice Krispie Cakes. Yes, well, these Rice Krispie Cakes are really good. So what you need, Rice Krispies, toffees, marshmallows, butter, and if you want, you can always get some cake cases. This is my flatmate Lib.
Adding some more Rice Krispies in.
Adding some more. Mixing it up. So Lib, what's your favourite thing to make?
My favourite thing to make is most probably cinnamon buns.
Cinnamon buns.
I make them almost every weekend.
Every Saturday I wake up to the smell of cinnamon buns. Out of 10. 10. 10 out of 10.
We'd even scrape the bowl, like to clean. So why don't you make your favourite thing? Either you can bake or you can cook something, and do share it with us. We'd love to see what you get up to. And feel free to try our recipe.
So excited to see you guys next week, so keep in touch. We'll see you guys at football. Peace.